Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss simple type. What is a simple type? The simple type is a unique object property identifier, even if two symbols have the same name. And the simple type is useful for adding some kind of hidden properties to your object. And I'm going to discuss global symbol registry. And finally, I'm going to discuss the advantage of using symbols. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The file is quite simple. I just have a title and a heading. And this HTML file is linked to a JavaScript file called myscript.js. And this JavaScript file is stored in the JS folder. In order for me to use the strict mode, I have to say use strict at the very beginning of the JavaScript file. And now let us discuss the simple type. When we set up object properties, we have only two possible ways. The first way is to use strings as the properties, and the second one is to use symbols, which is the topic right now. And what is a symbol? A symbol is a unique way of representing the properties, even though they have the same keys. And that means two distinct symbols can exist with the same key. For example, ABC. And ABC here is also called the description. So key and description are interchangeable in this case. So let me set up an example. Now I have two distinct symbols. The first one is called sim1 and the second one is called sim2. Even though they have the same keys or descriptions, the two symbols are different. How can I show it to you? I can just test their equality. So let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you see that sim1 is not equal to sim2. I use three equal signs to see whether they are strictly identical to each other. But you can see that they are not equal to each other, so you will see false as the answer. That means when we have the same keys, but when we set up two different symbols with two names, these two symbols are different entities in JavaScript. So this is the important property to remember when you use symbols. And now let me try to use symbols in the object properties. Actually, symbol values can be set up inside the object. So let me just set up a symbol before I declare an object. Now I have a symbol called sex, and the symbol key is just sex. And now I set up an object, which is a rabbit. Okay, I have a rabbit. I have two key value pairs. The first key value pair is just using a string as the key. And the second key value pair uses a symbol to be the key. So you can see that when I want to use a symbol as a key, I have to embrace the symbol with a pair of square brackets. Okay, so this is the way to use a symbol to become a certain key for your object. So the value of a symbol key must be accessed using a pair of square brackets. That is the way I use right now. And how can I access the value for this symbol key? Let me show you now. Okay, I can check the sex of a rabbit. In order to access the symbol key, I have to use a pair of square brackets. So let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you see the previous result, and let me show the current result. Yes, it is male, so I can use a pair of square brackets to access the value of a symbol key. So this is the major message I have to convey to you. Symbols are mainly used to add hidden properties that are not intended to be part of your object definition. In this case, we don't alter the original object definition. This is the way people usually use symbols, because they want to hide some properties that are not intended to be the object definition. This is a bit abstract, so I'm going to use a certain example to discuss the issue of hidden properties. Before I talk about the hidden properties, I have to say that the properties in symbol form can be added outside the object definition. So what does it mean by it here? Let me show you the meaning of this sentence by using the rabbit object again. Suppose I have a symbol called length. I want to add a new symbol to the original object called rabbit. So after this execution, I'm able to have three key value pairs. And when I want to check the key value pair, I just use the alert window. Let me save it and reload the page. Yes, you see the previous result, and now I'm able to see 20 coming out. So the key value pair about length of a rabbit is already added to the rabbit object. So now you have understood that we have three key value pairs. The first one, the second one, and the third one. Okay. And if we have simple keys, you can expect that the sex and the length are hidden properties to the object called rabbit. So if the properties are hidden, the for in loop doesn't show those symbols. So you can expect that both the sex and the length of properties are not able to be shown. How can I use a for in loop? Let me show you now. So I want to use a for in loop to loop over all the properties contained in the rabbit object. So let me save it and reload the page. Color is the property of a rabbit shown here. And that's the end. I cannot show the sex and the length properties because they are treated as the hidden properties of a certain object. Okay. So if we have symbols being the keys, these properties become hidden, and the for in loop isn't able to show them up. So that is the way people use symbols in general. And we said that symbols are distinct. Is there any way to make them indistinguishable? Yes, we have some ways to make them indistinguishable, which is called the global symbol registry. So if we put the symbols into the global symbol registry, the same symbols will represent the same property. So symbols with same keys or descriptions would really represent the same thing. So let me show you an example. Now I have two symbols. One is called prop1 and the other one is called prop2. And you can see that both symbols have the same key called def, being a string. And if we want to set up symbols in the global symbol registry, I have to use symbol.for instead of just using symbol. Okay, so if we use the keyword for in setting up a symbol, we can expect that the two symbols would represent the same thing. So let me check it now. So I want to see whether they are exactly equal to each other by using three equal signs. Okay, let me save it and reload the page. Yes, it is true that the two symbols with different names would be actually the same entity in the global symbol registry. So if we have two symbols in the global symbol registry, how can I access the keys of these symbols? Let me show you now. Okay, I just use key for method of a symbol to see where the content of both prop1 and prop2 are the same. Save, reload, yes, df, which is the key or the description of prop1, and for the other symbol called prop2, you can see the key is also def. So when you use key for method, I'm able to see the description of a certain symbol that are located in the global symbol registry. Okay. So we have already discussed the use of symbols quite a lot. But what is the advantage of using symbols? In addition to treat them as hidden properties, there is some real situation that is quite useful for us to use symbols. If an object and its outside code want to use the same identifier name, then a symbol can make sure that both identifiers stand for different things. It is quite abstract, but I'm able to show you an example to illustrate this point a bit more clearly. Suppose I have an empty object called employee. And then I'm able to set up some property value pair for this object. Suppose I want to say that the employee income is $4,000. I can add a certain key value pair using strings being the key. So income is just a certain string, but not a symbol currently. If I want to see the result coming from this key, I just use an alert window. And then we save it and reload the page. Yes, you can see that 4,000 comes out, which means the income of the certain employee in US dollars. But it is possible that some other programmers are trying to use your previous code to do some other things. For example, another part of the program wants to use UK pounds instead of US dollars to represent an income. So if that programmer does something like this one, the value of the income would be changed. The programmer wants to change the income to 3,000 UK pounds. So when I access the variable name again, you will see that $3,000 becomes the new value. Save. Reload. The original one was 4,000 in US dollars, but the current one becomes 3,000 UK pounds. But in many situations, you don't really want to overwrite the original key value pair with some new values. But you can see that for the income part here, two different programmers want to use different currencies to represent the same thing actually. So for 4,000 US dollars is roughly the same as 3,000 UK pounds. But two programmers want to use different currencies. So in order to address this problem, it is better to use symbols instead of strings to become the key of a certain object. So how can I address this problem by the use of symbols? Let me show you now. Now I set up a symbol called income, which is the same spelling as the original string key shown here. And then I can set this symbol key into the employee object as follows. Okay, I set up a certain symbol key, and the symbol key is assigned by 3,000 UK pounds. The property is now in the symbol format. And after setting up a certain symbol key, I can access both incomes from the symbol key as well as the string key. So let me show you the way. Now you can see that I have a string key and a symbol key. So when I run the program, I'm able to see two different income values. Save. Reload. Okay, the first string key represents the salary in US dollars, which is 4,000. And the second value refers to the symbol key, which stores the salary in UK pounds, so you can see 3,000 coming out. So if we use symbols, we can avoid the problem of overwriting your previous content of your object, which is not your intention to do so. So that's why when we use distinct symbols, we can address this kind of problem quite easily. So we can access both the string and the symbol keys without conflict. That is the major idea of using symbols instead of just using string as the keys. So this video has already discussed a lot of things about symbols. We have seen the way to define symbols, and we have seen the ways to add the symbols into the keys of a certain object. And we also know the meaning of global symbol registry, which is a place to treat symbols with the same names as the same. And we are also able to address the reason why we have to use symbol keys in order to avoid people from affecting your previous object content. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.